Video. Good morning, friends. Today is a day to congratulate the footwear industry for organizing this event. Also, to my colleague and friend, the chairman of IIFF, the former Home Secretary, Mr. Goel, because it's a collaborative effort between the Indian Trade Promotion Organization and the footwear industry. I want to congratulate them but also offer them my best wishes for a great future that lies ahead of them. The other day, Gupta ji, Dua ji and all his colleagues, they met me and we are discussing. Normally, we don't think little bit medium term and long term. We always think about immediate problems. Immediate problems are necessary to be solved because if you don't solve immediate problems, you'll never be to work. As one of our great saints, Vinobaji Bhave, used to say, which I quoted in my railway budget, when I presented a railway budget to the parliament, that if you work looking too far away, you will fall. But if you look so close to your feet and walk, you will stumble. So you must have a balance of understanding immediate problem, but cannot afford to forget and overlook the immediate problems to be addressed, but long-term view to be taken into account. And if you look at long-term and a medium-term, this is one industry which will have a huge potential to do. We used to say that roti, kapda and makan, and for my friends from Africa over here, will say food, shelter and clothing is very important. You cannot survive without it. But I can say, you cannot walk without shoes. And if you don't walk, what is the purpose you do? So to actually, walking is something which human beings learned first. For thousands of years, human beings were only walking, not thousands, almost billion years, they were only walking. Because there was no transport, nothing. So only walking. But that time they were walking because that time Guptaji was not born. Because they didn't know where to wear. So they would have all kinds of toilet. But in the modern times, every human being would like to have a pair of shoes or a pair of footwear. And as the population is going to grow, as the income level should increase, people will not like just to buy one pair, but many pairs. Someone for the evening, someone for the afternoon, someone maybe for dinner, somewhere in the monsoon, somewhere where everything. So just imagine, 7.3 billion population of the world. Each one of them, everybody cannot afford. But those who afford will buy more. Those who don't afford too many will buy few or one. And therefore the demand for the shoes and particularly the footwear is going to increase manifold. And this is the time to strategize and look around what are the potential and therefore try to make India and of course our friends from Africa in partnership with them a global hub for catering to global demand from these hotspots. You must try to set up manufacturing facilities, not just to cater to local market or national market. You must think about setting up factories and manufacturing capacities to cater to global market. And this is one industry which will continue to grow all the time. The design will change, fashion will change, but footwear will remain. As long as the foot is there, footwear will be there. And therefore, we have, and fortunately, unlike animals, human beings only have two footwear. Otherwise, animal would have taken four footwear, actually. But at least, we can clearly see a great future for them. And therefore, when they came to meet me, we have decided to create a strategic plan for this sector. A strategic plan which will take into account all aspects related to this. From raw material, to manpower, to finance, to locational issues, environmental issues, if any, all aspects, including how to link this to global markets. And therefore the global supply chain, which will be emerging in a big way in the world. The only global supply chains, and therefore I was saying, Africa and India can also collaborate. Because the supply chain would mean that maybe some part of that footwear can be manufactured here, if it gives a later advantage, something we can do. But end product will be made in such a way that it actually takes into account the potential of the supply chain. So we like to work on the strategy, and I already told them that let industry do their job and I will do my job as a government. I promise you that I will fulfill all the obligations and the responsibilities that this strategic plan will reveal, and I will be responsible to take it forward to make sure that India becomes a hub for global manufacturing of footwear and allied industry. This is one industry which will create huge employment. And that's why labor intensive, mass consumption, always in demand product is footwear. So this is a product for all seasons and all times to come. And therefore, all these are going to be the major concerns of the world, particularly the developing world like Africa and India. Job, something which will last for long so that it doesn't become redundant, what a capacity to create. Modernization, of course, is necessary all the time in any industry. But redundancy will not happen. And therefore, it's a good time to do it. As we're discussing that day, that China will be moving out of some of these products. In fact, I already directed my additional secretary, and he is now in China today. I told him to go there and find out how we can bring some of these production lines, which will not be now in China, so that we will be able to work and make sure that India will become a new hub for supplying to the rest of the world. And we are really working on it. I am very happy to say that this Council for Leather Industry, Mr. Amir, is sitting here. And we have already given a leather package of 2,600 crores. And Mr. Amir is the chairman of it. And he's doing a good job. In fact, we launched it in Kanpur, when we went there. Day after tomorrow, we'll be in Chennai to have a meeting with all the leather industry day after tomorrow, on Saturday. And therefore, all the time I'm going around and trying to make sure that this industry becomes relevant. 2,600 crore package involves many things. Modernization of leather industry, common effluent treatment plant, particularly for the tanneries, skill development, giving training centers, many aspects of that are covered by this. I already talked to the state governments. I was in West Bengal the other day in the UP, in Tamil Nadu. I talked to all the state chief ministers that they must support this industry in a very aggressive way. All the state governments are coming forward, and I was just not telling Guptaji, you tell me 5-6 states in which you want to set up a big cluster for the footwear industry. And I will make sure that the state government will give you the land as well as necessary infrastructure. And then we'll have a joint effort to train people so that human resource also is available. So let us work in a collaborative way and try to do it in a big way. As you are aware, India's exports for 2017-18 grew for the first time after 6 years in a record growth year registered in 2017-18. And the last few months, our exports have been growing at almost 20%. So I think it's a very good sign, but the global situation for trade is not very good, not very conducive. But I'm sure we'll be able to address it if we have proper strategy. As a country like India, and as a commerce minister, under leadership of my prime minister, we already decided that we'll have good relations with all countries in the world. As far as trade is concerned, we don't want to have any issues with anybody, whether it's United States, whether it's Europe, whether it's Africa, whether it is Latin America, whether it is East Asia, whether it is Southeast Asia, we'll have relations with all countries in a very, very progressive way. In fact, in Africa, we are doing in a very aggressive way. In East Africa, in Uganda, we had a meeting of 11 countries. In Southern Africa, in Johannesburg, we had a meeting with Southern African countries. I will again go to Kenya in this month, later this month, and we'll have this meeting. I was in North Africa. And therefore, the idea is that we like to develop relationship with all our friends in Africa. And these 54 countries in Africa will be our partners, and we like to grow with them. I'm happy to say that for the first time, we have changed completely the project financing mode. Exim Bank of India has been provided with additional capital. The Export Credit Guarantee Corporation has been given additional capital. And the idea is that we'll promote project export from India to our friends in Africa in a manner that Africa will benefit from it. Because we don't want to do anything which will only benefit India. We want to benefit India but also benefit our friends in Africa. So we like to work in that particular way, and we are already working out the strategy. And yesterday also we have put in the cabinet a very important decision of how new norms for project financing, which are very friendly to the countries where we will be doing this business with, have been approved. So now we will be working very aggressively. So I think we will be very happy to take this idea forward. Let me repeat, we are preparing a strategic vision for the footwear industry. And this is not Prime Minister's preparing. We are preparing it jointly with the industry and the government. And the job of the government will be, wherever the identified role of the government is implemented, we'll implement it fully. As I just now mentioned to him, we'll take forward with the state government wherever need help. And luckily, we have gone to my home state because I was a member of parliament of Haryana. I think all great leaders come from Haryana, including Mr. Goel and Mr. Gupta. So I think Haryana is a very good place, but if you want any other state, in south, in north, wherever, we'll actually like to develop it and we'll work together. So once again, all the best to you. Congratulations to all the participants. Welcome to my friends who have come from Africa, and we really have great love for Africa. So nice to see you here. I'm sure you will enjoy the place, and also you'll be able to take some shoes from here when you go back to Africa. So really, thank you very much. Congratulations to all of you.
Thank you very much, sir. Encouraging words. Now, I would like to invite.
This is the first time we are doing it. We need to
do it.
Being a mechanical engineer.
बड़े वाला बेटा
सर 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 लुक
ये दोनों केमिकल इंजीनियर
फॉर कॉमन मैन दिस इज लाइक वेरी लेकिन बाय फॉर 1000 रुपीस
ताकि सीसा
ले 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 तू ले
ना ना ले नहीं तो मेरा सीसा
अंतर्राष्ट्रीय लेदर फेयर के बारे में पहले
देखिए पूरे विश्व में
यार हरियाणा
में बढ़ती हुई आबादी साथ साथ में लोगों की बढ़ती हुई उत्पन्न की स्थिति उसको ध्यान में रखते हुए हमें जरूर कह सकते हैं कि आने वाले दिनों में फुटवेयर की मांग बहुत बड़े पैमाने पे बढ़ने वाली है।
घर जाओ यार, घर आ जाओ।
आज भी हमारे देश में बहुत सारे लोग नंगे पाँव घूमते हैं, लेकिन उनको भी जरूरी, उनकी भी एक ख्वाहिश रहती है कि कम से कम एक जूता एक चप्पल पहनी जाए। इसके लिए उनके लिए भी हवाई चप्पल बनाने का एक सिलसिला देश में शुरू हुआ। धीरे धीरे उनकी भी आयु, जब से उनकी भी जैसे आयु बढ़ती गई है, उसी तरह से उनके भी नए नए जूते खरीदने की ख्वाहिश वो भी बढ़ती गई है। इसलिए आने वाले दिनों में बड़ी मात्रा में फुटवेयर इंडस्ट्री विदेश में और देश में बढ़ने वाली है। हमारी ये उम्मीद होनी चाहिए कि किस तरह से हम पूरे विश्व की मांग जो रहेगी उसको पूरी करने के लिए हमारे देश में किस तरह से मैन्युफैक्चरिंग करेंगे। इसलिए हम लोगों ने एक 2600 करोड़ रुपये का पैकेज भी बनाया जो पूरे सिर्फ लेदर इंडस्ट्री के लिए, अभी फुटवेयर और बाकी जो रिलेटेड इंडस्ट्रीज है उनके लिए भी किस तरह से मदद की जा सकती है उसके भी सोचेंगे। लेकिन हम लोगों ने तय किया है कि एक बड़ा स्ट्रेटेजिक प्लान, बिजनेस प्लान हमारे पूरे फुटवेयर और इस इंडस्ट्री के लिए बनाया जाए। जो प्लान हम पूरी मात्रा में अमल में लाएंगे, इसमें इंडस्ट्री अपना योगदान देगी, सरकार अपनी जिम्मेदारी निभाएंगी, और साथ ही में हम दोनों मिलकर ये काम करेंगे कि बड़ी मात्रा में देश में किस तरह से रोजगार उपलब्ध किए जाए। मुझे लगता है सिर्फ इस उद्योग से लाखों रोजगार, नए रोजगार देश में निर्माण किए जाएंगे। और एक अच्छी बात यह है कि हमारी इंडस्ट्री के जो लोग मुझे बातचीत कर रहे हैं उनका ये कहना है कि आप उन्हें हम करेंगे, ये तो एक बहुत बड़ी बात है। ये तो हम कहीं जाके लोग बोलते रहे ये प्रॉब्लम है, वो प्रॉब्लम है, तो ये लोग कहते प्रॉब्लम तो बहुत है लेकिन हम उसको संभाल के हम ये इंडस्ट्री को बहुत आगे ले चलेंगे। तो ये जो एक उम्मीद इन लोगों में दिखाई दे रही है, मुझे लगता है आने वाले दिनों की एक बहुत बड़ी सुनहरी एक शुरुआत है। और इसलिए प्रधानमंत्री जो न्यू इंडिया की बात कर रहे हैं, तो न्यू इंडिया इसी तरह से बनेगी, इस तरह से हमारे लोग खुद कहेंगे कि हम ये करना चाह रहे हैं, पूरे विश्व की मार्केट काबिज करना चाह रहे हैं, उसके लिए काम करेंगे, यहाँ पे लाखों लोगों को रोज़गार देंगे, और सरकार हमको सिर्फ मदद करे जहाँ सरकार की जिम्मेदारी है, उससे ज़्यादा उनकी कोई अपेक्षा भी नहीं है, तो ये हम जरूर काम करेंगे और हम हमें जिम्मेदारी हम निभाएंगे।
थैंक यू सर, ठीक है सर,
रास्ते में चले।
थैंक यू सो मच।
$100
is the MRP, but our
sir, medicine made it.